Serapis Bey's address. May I say something startling to you? You know, individuals among mankind are so frightfully disturbed about their money supply. Do you know it is the easiest thing in the world? Do you know the natural flow of your life stream, uninterrupted, would actually produce the money supply in your hands every day which you need for use? It actually would do it. Then why has it not done it? Because of your constant interruption of this life stream by discord in your feelings. That is why. I say the supply of the money you require for use is and should be the easiest part of your achievement. But if your pocketbook begins to get a little flat, and there is not so very much change in your pocket, oh, what a trembling fear comes over you. Those bills on the table at home, staring you in the face, are saying, "How are you going to take care of me?" Then you succumb to the suggestion, when if you would rise up in the power of your presence and say, "Don't you talk back to me. Mighty I Am Presence, take charge of those bills. See that they are paid through the power of divine love and keep my human agitation off them." How quickly they would be paid. Do you not see, blessed ones, the only reason problems exist or bills accumulate is because of your disturbance and agitation. Such feeling does not allow enough of the power of the presence to get through undisturbed and uninterrupted to produce the conditions which bring it about quickly. That is the only reason you do not have it. You think persons, places, and conditions are to blame. Oh, loved ones, erase that from your minds, please, if you want to be free. Not all the human beings in creation can interfere with one of you in the money supply and everything else you require, when you stand one with your presence and keep your attention there. Refuse to accept that the appearance of the world, which breeds of discord and human limitations, have any power. Oh, the messengers have pled with mankind to refuse acceptance of the appearance world, yet they have not seemed able to do it. Beloved ones, will you try this? We must help you gain the victory. Now let us just, pardon me if I use your expression, pep up and do it. Oh, do not wobble around any longer. Come into the law of life and let it take its dominion and stop the human wobbling. Precious ones, with this God power and presence, the intelligence and power of the universe beating your hearts, moving your bodies about, then there is nothing of human creation which can interfere with the outpouring of the presence to produce it in your world. It is impossible for you to fail. Take that stand and say to all human appearance, "No longer dare you attempt to hold me in your bondage. With my God presence I shatter and blast to pieces everything that has been accumulated about me. I walk forth this hour free from all human limitations." We must shatter this power of human creation, which has held its bondage upon mankind. If you will join me tonight, while you are sitting here listening, if you will join me in your feelings, and let this power be released in your mind, body, and world of activity, then this night it shall be shattered. You shall walk forth in the morning, free, forever. There is no power anywhere in the universe that can interfere with your own stream of life, flowing into your mind and body, and then out into your world, if your attention is undivided. Do whatever is required in the outer world, and the moment that is finished, turn your attention back to the presence. If it is only for 1 minute, in that minute, make your call. Mighty I Am Presence, take dominion in this body and my world. Produce your perfection and hold your dominion. When you call it forth like that, you will have it, dear people. You cannot have your victory if you just wish for a thing, when you need to demand its release. You must mean business in your call to the presence. You must be firm, unyielding, and determined. Then the full and complete release will come quickly. I plead with you, Do not longer yield to the appearance world which has frightened you so long. As long as you give it power, energy which is your life, then it will come back and say, I am still your master. Yet here above you is the great master of all life, who offers you all there is in the universe as a free gift of love, just through the acceptance. Will you not see how easy it is? It only requires firm determination at first to bring this release. Let us draw just a little illustration here. Suppose after you return home tonight, you immediately say, that all sounds very good, but here are these things. And then these things will have you by the throat. I wonder if you will make just a little extra effort tonight when you go home. If you see something there that is not desirable, instead of succumbing to its appearance, say to that thing, you are finished. You scared me once, but you will never do it again. Whether it is bills or something else, do you know what you would do? The minute you will stand up before everything which confronts your world and show it you are not afraid of it, it will just crumple up and crawl at your feet and say, thank you, I have found my master. That is what those appearances will do. Every appearance in this world is a coward. Every agitator in this world is a coward at heart and a fiend, believe it or not. When humanity rises up and says, there shall not be another agitator in our America, and everyone that pops his head up, pop it down, you will be free from that thing. The idea of hundreds of thousands of people succumbing to an insane agitator. Dear people, in the name of God, call forth your power from the presence to silence those things forever. Many are innocent. They do not know they are being made claws of the sinister force, which is wholly destructive. Even though they do not know the difference, they are producing the same results as if they were not innocent. Therefore, dear people, the time has come when your call to the presence must be strong enough to silence these things in your midst. Dear ones, you have before you the evidence. Think of the condition of your city when the messengers came here last time. These great hotels had been closed for months. Before the class was over, they opened. Because of the call for the power of light to shatter that condition from your city, it was done. Is there an agitator or anybody else that can say it was not done? I want you to see the light, the authority which is within your own precious life. It is the master of every condition that ever confronts you. It does not matter what is going on around you. One with this mighty I Am presence is a majority. And is not the light more powerful than the darkness? Before you turned these lights on in the room, it was quite dark, was it not? You sometimes call it pitch dark. Well, when you turned the light on, was there any battle? The darkness just disappeared, did it not? It is exactly the same law acting when you call this power of light. Let us first take you individually. When you call this power of light into action to flood your being and world, exactly the same thing takes place as took place in this room when you turned on these lights. Now the darkness of your own human creation is not a particle more powerful than the darkness in this room before you turned on the lights. If you came in with a candle, you would not see so clearly, would you? But when you come in with these great lights turned on, the darkness has disappeared. Just for a moment, think of the greater light you have in the outer world today, the most powerful one. Compare that with the power of your presence, which is the light of the world. Then, has your human creation any power, the darkness of it, against this light which you can call forth to flood your being and world, which dissolves all darkness and lets the power of the light take its dominion? Now, I am going to say something else, quite shocking to you. There are 75% of the students in San Francisco, Oakland and vicinity, who have time and again in their intense call had their freedom, but they did not have the patience to wait a few days for it to manifest. Will you believe that I am telling you the truth? This is an actual fact, the actual truth. You have at times made such determined, sincere call that the freedom was released, but because it was not a miracle or instantaneous manifestation, you allowed the attention to go back into the limitations. I am saying this tonight for a very great purpose, because if I am to help you, I am going to do something worthwhile, or I will not do it. If I am going to help in this business, you are not going to wobble around anymore. You are not going to go back into the acceptance of those limitations when we have called forth your freedom. Remember that the next time you wobble. Remember, I am right here. If you get a good prodding up, do not blame me, because you will receive a good sound reminder that you are sleeping. Dear ones, I do not wish to make you overconscious because of the need, but you are at a point when you can have your freedom so quickly. I want you to have it. All the Ascended Masters, Saint Germain included, want you to have it. I am a new element, so to speak, to have come into the scenery, and if we do not get some results, I am going to know why. Now I mean business. You blessed ones are not going to yield and begin to wobble around in these outer things after tonight. Do not do it. You are going to brace up and take your dominion in the power of your presence and say to everything undesirable in your way, "You are finished right now. Get out." Do not say that to your husbands and wives, but I am speaking about conditions. Dear ones, we do not become too serious, you know, and yet we must be firm. You would hardly believe that with all my firmness, the greatest imaginable happiness is within my being, but in my attainment, beloved ones, the ascended ones will quite agree that few ever went through such fierceness as I did. My human was the most stubborn thing ever encountered. I hope you do not encounter that which I did. I know what it means when the human is so determined within the individual to have its own way. And I tell you, dear people, do not yield to it for a single instant. The more determined the human is, the more firm you must become in calling the powers of the presence into action to dissolve it. We, for many centuries, have called to us from all parts of the world those who we felt were ready for their freedom in the light. But remember, even the Ascended Master, until the individual has reached a certain point in the expansion of his light, cannot tell what the human is going to do. Now this is the point I am coming to. In those who were called to us from all parts of the world, for a time their enthusiasm, notice this point careful. Their enthusiasm would be wonderful, their determination something wonderful. But after a few weeks, the human within them began to rebel good and strong at the obedience. Then you would see their enthusiasm go down and down and down and down. Instead of a glowing smile, there would come that bedraggled look. Sometimes when I would tap them on the shoulder and say, "Oh, it is not so serious as it seems. Brace up. Come back into that old enthusiasm. Where do you suppose it went to?" Be careful you don't lose it. It is still within reach. Hang on to it. Sometimes they would take hold immediately and come back. Those would always win the victory. But when I tapped them on the back to give them the encouragement, and that smile failed to appear, I knew the condition was dangerous. Sometimes those would come back, and sometimes they did not. And of all things, those students would swear to you that I did not care whether they succeeded or failed, because in my capacity I did not show to them my feeling. The most difficult thing in our entire experience is to see the marks there for those who failed, perhaps only temporarily, but nevertheless they had to try again. You think you meet difficulties, but precious ones, not until the day you too stand in that same position will you realize what it means to us. The conditions of the outer world and the things you meet today are really nothing at all in comparison to that one condition. to see a beloved, blessed one with not enough strength or light within him to win the victory is sorrow indeed. If there be sorrow in a perfected state, then that would be one place it would manifest. Beloved ones, instead of a few individuals whom we drew to us from all parts of the world, today your beloved Saint Germain has gathered about him thousands and thousands of people, giving forth this same identical law which we gave forth after a 4-year probation. This was never known in the outer world. Even with those who failed and returned to the outer world, their sense of honor never allowed them to mention the laws which had been taught. That is one thing wherein the great law of life acts, and we who represent it are eternally and everlastingly grateful. Because in the training during their stay with us, a certain honor was established which never left them. Beloved ones, what a magnificent opportunity you have. Can you, will you fully appreciate it? In the comfort of a beautiful room like this, in the lovely homes and the magnificent places which the messengers have for you, you are receiving the great law which people sought for over the entire earth and were eternally grateful for having found it. Do you realize, precious ones? Do you appreciate what is before you? I am sure you do, and you will daily appreciate it more and more. If you listen to human beings who breathe the poison of discord, doubt, and fear into your world, then you are responsible. Do you not see that? Do you not see why you must be the decreer and governor of your world? You can shut out whatever you do not want. You do not have to listen to false gossip and all that kind of thing which breeds poison into your world. The pitiful thing is the condition of those who breathe such thing forth into the world of others. It may disturb them temporarily, but the persons who breathe it forth will cry out in agony for the falsehoods they have uttered. It does not make any difference what or who it is. It is the law of life. I marvel at those who have thought I was severe, but the law of life is more so, because it never prompts you, it just waits. And if you want to misuse its energy, it says, just run along, you will get tired of it. But we who know these conditions prompt and prompt and prompt mankind. Sometimes they do not believe us and they go on. But those who do accept our help and with great loving feeling determine to give obedience, then how quickly joy and perfection begin to fill their worlds.